Now, let us see about a skin lesion which does not confine itself to the skin but has also systemic manifestations related to it. It is systemic lupus erythematosus. So, what is SLE? It is an autoimmune disease characterized by autoantibodies, immune complex formation and immune dysregulation resulting in damage to essentially any organ. 80-90% of the lupus patients are female. 80% of lupus patients are between 15 to 45 years of age. The ratio of females to male is 2:1 in early age before puberty or 4:1 after puberty. So what is the etiology of systemic lupus erythematosus? The specific cause is still unknown, but it is believed that genetic factors may play a main role. Environmental agents like sunlight, etc. have also a role. Then hormones, drugs or other chemical agents, dietary factors, ultraviolet radiation and infectious agents. Then pathogenesis, as we know earlier, it is a disease due to immune dysregulation. Antibodies against the immune systems are formed. They are autoantibodies. In SLE, against which antigens these autoantibodies are formed? They are formed against DNA, other nuclear antigens, ribosomes, platelets, erythrocytes, leukocytes, and other tissue-specific antigens. The clinical features is characterized by states of exacerbation and remission. Under skin manifestations, we can have four solid points. They are butterfly rash, discoid rash. It is especially seen in discoid lupus erythematosus. We'll see about it later. Then photosensitivity and oral ulcers. Under systemic manifestations, we have four main points, including arthritis, serositis, that is inflammation of pericardium and pleurium, then kidney disorder and neurological disorder. Let's see in detail about the cutaneous lesions first. Erythematous patches, roughly symmetrical pattern over cheek across the bridges of the nose. Therefore, it is called as butterfly distribution since it resembles a butterfly. Then also it is seen in the neck, upper arms, shoulders and fingers. Lesions also have an itching and burning sensation. Hyperpigmentation is evident and these features are intensified by sunlight. The systemic features commonly seen involves the kidney. In kidney, we could see the fibrinoid thickening of the glomerular capillaries producing characteristic wire loop appearance. In heart, we have atypical endocarditis, which is the fibrinoid degeneration of the epicardium and the myocardium. Then in collagen diseases, we could see a group of features like rheumatic fever, rheumatoid arthritis, polyarthritis nodosa and scleroderma, etc. Being dentists, we need to concentrate on the oral manifestations of systemic lupus erythematosus. The oral ulcers with hyperemia, edema, and greater tendency for bleeding are evident. Then petechiae is also evident. Superficial ulcerations are surrounded by red halo, which indicates localized telangiectasis. We have to know some of the histopathological features. You should remember that these features are not pathognomonic of systemic lupus erythematosus. The features include hyperkeratosis with keratotic plugging, atrophy of the retipex, then basophilic degeneration of collagen and elastic fibers with hyalinization. Let us move to another important point regarding investigations of systemic lupus erythematosus. The first thing we have to concentrate is the presence of ANA, anti-nuclear antibodies. And we should be careful that ANA is also detectable in certain other diseases and is not pathognomonic. Then immunological investigations such as positive anti-double-stranded anti-DNA test, then positive anti-Smith antibody test, then presence of anti-RNP, ribonucleophosphate antibodies helps in confirmation. The second most important thing which we investigate is the hematological investigation, which indicates hemolytic anemia, leukopenia, lymphopenia or thrombocytopenia. Then increased ESR, as in any inflammation, increased CRP is also detected. If kidney is involved, increased serum urea and creatinine. And if muscle is involved, increased enzyme CPK, that is creatinine phosphokinase, is seen. Treatment goal is to relieve symptoms and protect organs by decreasing inflammation. The treatment includes rest or sleep, NSAIDs, corticosteroids, anti-malarial drugs and cytotoxic drugs. Discoid lupus erythematosus is characterized by a chronic scarring atrophy producing photosensitive dermatosis. We could also see heat shock proteins are induced in keratinocyte following UV light, which is the main implication in the pathogenesis of EDLE. Then forceful removal of the scales revealed numerous carpet tack extensions in DLE. The main complication in DLE is healed scar can lead to squamous cell carcinoma or basal cell carcinoma. Now friends, I think I have summarized SLE and DLE within a short time as much as possible. Hope this video was useful to you in your exam preparations.